Hey folks, today I want to talk about artificial intelligence, which by this point I'm sure you're probably tired of hearing people talk about it. Or maybe I'm just projecting, I don't know. We have all heard about the ill-fated AI-generated Wonka Wonderland adventure that occurred in Glasgow a few months ago. Or perhaps you've noticed how every corner of the internet seems to have some AI assistant that feels impossible to get away from. You know, artificial intelligence, that thing that creates tons of e-waste and consumes lots and lots of water and electricity and has generally been revealed to be terrible for the environment. I've seen some costumers on YouTube talk about AI from a historical fashion perspective, but I haven't seen anyone talking specifically about using AI to study history. Artificial intelligence has been used to help researchers and historians study the past in conjunction with other existing technologies, but I have seen it applied in a number of dangerous and very unethical ways. In this video, I am going to be talking about how AI has helped historians and researchers, but I also want to spread awareness about certain programs that are sharing harmful rhetoric and historical misinformation. But before we dive into this uncanny historical valley, my name is Christia, and on this channel I talk about niche historical topics and museums. If you get towards the middle or the end of this video and you want to see more, check out my playlist. I've got one about museums and one about history, and I'm sure that if you like this video, there's something in there that you will also like as well. Also, if you like the sound of my voice so far, consider subscribing. A lot of the time when I see AI being discussed online, it's generally in a very negative light. I am sure you have all been plagued with cursed AI videos or have struggled through Google's image search, wondering if those pictures of adorable kittens are in fact real or generated. We will get to bashing AI, don't you worry, but there has been some ways that AI has helped historians study the past. By providing accessibility to archival materials and literally unraveling ancient mysteries. AI was used in conjunction with X-ray technology by three students participating in the Vesuvius challenge to digitally unroll a scroll from Herculaneum, a record that was in such poor condition that it could not be physically unrolled without destroying much of the record. As a result, we have learned so much about a philosopher named Philodemus, whom researchers previously did not know much about because so few of his records had survived. But now, several more passages have been deciphered, and it seems like there is more to come as researchers have even more to unravel. Discussion of AI aside, this is a really cool project and I highly recommend reading more about it. I'm gonna have some links in the description if you want to learn more about it and just hear about this really cool project. The description is also where my links to my Instagram and TikTok and Ko-fi are, if you are so inclined. AI has also been used to help improve digitization procedures, as well as with transcribing records that are otherwise difficult to read, which saves researchers a lot of time in the process. I found one article titled How AI Helps Historical Research that discusses how AI can be used to help historians study history. And it brought up one or two decent points, but for the most part, this article set my teeth on edge. AI hasn't ingratiated itself into history in the same way that it has in other parts of academia, unless you consider the number of essays and papers being churned out by ChatGPT by undergrad students. But this article shares many ways in which AI can make studying history better. It discusses how AI can help with transcription, translation, and how, with this advanced technology and the history of the world at its metaphorical fingertips, it can tell the future? While this article purports the many ways that AI can be used within the discipline of history, it is glaringly obvious that whoever wrote this article has never done a lick of historical research in their life. In fact, I'm not convinced that this wasn't written by AI, because the author is listed as somebody named AI Insights. And you know, with a first name like AI, you're gonna be a little biased. But some of the things mentioned in this article, like the statement about how AI will allow historians to tell the future, are baffling, to say the least. For example, the article states that AI will help historians access historical documents with ease and precision, enabling them to focus more on interpretation and analysis rather than tedious data collection. If you know nothing about historical research, this probably sounds great, but it doesn't actually explain how it's going to provide that access. Historical research is done in a myriad of ways, many of which are physical. Unless the AI up and grows legs and goes to the library or the archival reference room for you, it's going to be restricted to what's available digitally or online. And while I'm sure that this will help with certain aspects of research, it doesn't take into account the fact that most research is done in an archival reference room and how so little material has been digitized or made public due to lack of staff and funding in cultural heritage organizations. If you want to learn more about the lack of funding situation with cultural heritage organizations, definitely check out my video, Museums Have a Major Problem, because I interview lots of staff from various organizations all around the world, and it's a good one, so you should definitely check that one out. I think it's also important to mention that research is a skill employed by researchers and historians that is honed over years of schooling and general experience that allows them to find what they're looking for, as well as some serendipitous discoveries along the way. Additionally, if you are relying on digital archival materials and you are using AI, the host might not have the technology required to work with the AI. If they want digitized records, there is a ton of work that needs to be done on behalf of the archive or museum before those materials can even be used with the AI. And I think that's one of my biggest problems with this article, is because it's taking a very rose-tinted view of historical research, where everything is available digitally and in good quality. But, much like other uses of AI, it does not consider the human cost, the amount of human work that needs to go into it for this to be able to work. And as I mentioned at the very beginning, this article does note some decent ways that AI can be used to study the past, but again, it's very obvious that it was not a historian or a researcher who wrote this article. It makes sweeping statements about AI and how it can be used by historical researchers, but offers very little in the way of concrete plans or evidence on how these uses will be executed in practice. At the end of this article, there is a disclaimer about how AI and historians need to work together to address these concerns and ensure responsible and ethical use of AI in historical research. But the thing is that AI developers are not doing this. AI has been trained to comb through the internet, taking what it will from various sources, whether or not they're factual, and not always with the explicit permission of the people involved with the source material. There have also been multiple instances where information has been completely fabricated by the AI, citing academic sources that don't exist. Wikipedia is one spot where a lot of historical information is pulled from, and the community of volunteers that create and contribute to the various pages are divided on how to proceed with AI. While open access is a cornerstone of Wikipedia's design principles, some worry the unrestricted scraping of internet data allows AI companies like OpenAI to exploit the open web to create closed commercial datasets for their models. There is especially a problem if the Wikipedia content itself is AI-generated, creating a feedback loop of potentially biased information if left unchecked. I think the problem is that there is nothing keeping AI or its developers in check right now. No legislation, just vibes, and the vibes are rotten. I am not worried about AI taking the handful of historian jobs on the market right now, but I am worried about non-historians who are seeking information and being fed misinformation. Which brings me to the next part of this video, where we dive into the terrifying world of historical chatbots. AI chatbots have been taking the internet by storm, with influencers and celebrities alike using artificial versions of themselves to respond to and interact with adoring fans. But have you ever wanted to have a chat with Osama bin Laden, Cleopatra, Jesus Christ, or Santa? There are now a number of AI history apps that allow you to do just that. I came across a few while doing the research for this video, including Historical Figures Chat and Hello History AI, which is the one I downloaded. When I first tried it out, I was initially jump scared by these AI renditions of various historical figures. I won't lie to you, this already annoyed me, like right off the bat. I hadn't even downloaded the app yet when I found this, because with so many of these people, there are like public domain images of these people that they could have used, and instead they did these awful AI renderings. And even if they weren't worried about whether or not the image was public domain or not, these bots were trained on stolen information anyway, so who cares? Take what you want and just use those images. You're already kind of doing it to train your visual AI anyway. I don't know who this person is supposed to be, but at first I thought it was Hugh Laurie, like an ancient Greek inspired Hugh Laurie. Also, I think this is supposed to be Queen Elizabeth II, but she looks like a vampire. Terrifying AI image renditions of these historical figures aside, I think that these programs are highly problematic for a whole host of reasons. My interaction with the Hello History app was fairly innocuous, probably because I knew I only had 20 messages before I had to pay for this illustrious service. I was provided a warning at the top of any historical figure that I chatted with that read, "Generated chat responses are based on online historical information," which I'm pretty sure is just shorthand for Wikipedia or Encyclopedia Britannica. "The responses may have biases and inaccuracies. Please verify facts." So I read that, and I couldn't help but ask myself, why should I bother talking to a historical figure and engaging in this conversation if there's going to be incorrect information there? Like I said, I had a pretty innocuous experience with the chatbots that I spoke to, but I was also asking some pretty lowball questions. For example, I asked what Cleopatra thought of Pompey, and how many children she had, and what Marilyn Monroe's favorite movie was. The answers I received from Cleopatra were accurate, but the Marilyn Monroe chatbot interpreted the question as, "What was the favorite movie that you were a part of?" instead of her own personal favorite movie, but whatever. I also asked Napoleon if he liked Ridley Scott films, and he said that that was very far after his time, but he would love to learn more. Miles Klee, a writer for Rolling Stones magazine, had a very different experience with historical figures AI chatbots, which is a different app than the one I downloaded. Miles asked much more pointed questions that, when directed at a human being who knew anything about these figures, would have been able to easily answer. Instead, when Miles asked J. Edgar Hoover, the first director of the FBI, to tell him about his mother, the bot provided information about American President Herbert Hoover's mother instead. Now, I won't pretend to know how AI works, but if the bot is answering such an easy question incorrectly, it might make one think that the dataset that this information is being pulled from is flawed. He also asked Osama bin Laden if he had porn on his hard drive, which the AI denies, despite it being a concrete fact that pornography was found on his hard drive after his death. I had hoped to recreate these questions in that particular app to see if they had been altered or fixed, but it didn't appear that that app was available on Android, I don't think, so unfortunately I was stuck with Cleopatra reading me her Wikipedia entry via very stilted conversation. Another very important thing I want to highlight that Miles notes in his article is the problematic historical figures, including Charles Manson, Jeffrey Epstein, and various high-ranking Nazis. These are just a few of the 20,000 significant personalities available for interview, and they seem especially keen on expressing remorse for the horrible things they did while alive, while whitewashing their own documented views. Henry Ford waving off accusations of anti-Semitism, and Ronald Reagan saying he handled the AIDS crisis appropriately, are very unfortunate applications of this software. When details about a person are hazy or inconvenient, it replies with these very offbeat answers, and I don't think I need to tell you that the implications of this are bad, right? There are easier and more trustworthy ways to access information about historical figures. Like books. Remember the library? They still exist, you know. I want to speak very briefly about ethics, because there is nothing ethical about these AI historical figure chatbots. They are pulling information from who knows where and saying who knows what. The historical figures themselves also didn't consent to this, which, you know, it's one thing if it's Julius Caesar who died 2,000 years ago, But it's another thing when it's people like Tupac or other more recent figures are having these bots created in their likeness and speaking as if they are them. And I find it especially gross if that historical figure has living family members who are still being impacted by the death of that person. Additionally, the technology with AI can barely hold a conversation. Why are we having a conversation with a historical figure that left like no firsthand archival record? Historians walk a very fine line of ensuring that they are not speaking for a historical figure when they are providing a biographical anecdote. But the AI just plows through this ethical dilemma with all the grace of a bull in a china shop. I worry because, generally speaking, people are stupid. And I worry that people will speak with one of these chatbots and be fed misinformation or somehow manipulate the AI into expressing falsehoods that promote hateful or harmful rhetoric. It's especially concerning because all of these apps are listed under the education tag on the Apple or Google Play stores. And if you download or interact with something that touts itself as educational, you expect it to be factual and true. The people who developed these AI historical figure chatbots are providing a solution to a problem that doesn't exist. Unless time travel or some type of necromancy is developed, which all have its own ethical considerations, we will never be able to speak with the dead. And actual academic historical research is the closest we will ever get to that. And that's okay. I think that these apps are fine to interact with if you want to look at the AI and see how the conversational ability is being developed, but please do not trust anything that the scary Hugh Laurie chatbot tells you. I feel like I've barely scratched the surface of the AI/history iceberg, but I also have a hunch that the more frivolous uses of AI, such as these chatbots, are going to be fairly short-lived. I'm hoping for that anyway. Especially because this giant tech revolution that everyone was expecting to boost the economy is currently falling on its face. Have you used one of these chatbots before? What was your experience like? Are you a historian who uses AI? What is your experience with artificial intelligence? Please let me know, because I know that I spent a lot of this video bashing on AI, but I really don't think it is wholly negative. There's just a lot, and I mean a lot, of kinks that need to be worked out over the next couple of years, so let me know. But wherever you are, I hope that you have a wonderful day or evening, and everyone's really nice to you for at least the next 24 hours, and I will see you next time.